you would like to supervise Hirschmann HiOS-based products in a third-party network management system, you will need to know which MIB object IDs to use. The Hirschmann private MIBs are descriptively named, and each MIB object ID is well documented inside the MIB. But there are many MIB object IDs. How do you know which ones to select for your application? In this video, I'll show you how to find out which object IDs are used in the Hirschmann graphical user interface. This will enable you to select the values you require and use them as the foundation for your own supervision solution. For this exercise, I'm using the Chrome browser. Now you see the standard Hirschmann graphical user interface. Press Ctrl, Shift, and J to open the developer tools. Then open the network menu. You'll see packets of data being sent between the browser interface and the switch agent. The communication uses a protocol called MIB Oriented Protocol Service, or MOPS. This is a protocol which is proprietary to Hirschmann. The data inside the packet is based on the SNMP format. If you wait a few seconds, you'll see some polling packets between the browser and the switch agent. These are not so interesting for us, but let's take a look anyway. Stop the recording, then select the first packet. What you see in capital letters is the name of a MIB, and below that you see the MIB variables which are being polled. In this case, it's some diagnostic information, which is used to update the mini dashboard at the top of the switch GUI main page. The next packet contains no useful data. The next few packets are repeats of the first poll. Then there is a different poll. Then back to the first poll. At this stage, don't be concerned about these polls. You will quickly learn what information is useful. Let's turn our attention to the GUI screen on the left. It contains information which will fit perfectly in a network supervision application. For example, the current temperature of the switch and the status of the power supplies. So let's find the MIB variables which are used for these values. Start the recording, reload the GUI page, stop the recording. Now let's take a look at what we've got. The first packet is the familiar poll. The second packet is also a poll we saw previously. The remaining packets look interesting. We start with a closer look at the third packet. We are looking for MIB variables which mention temperature, and here you see them. Current temperature is 43 degrees. Upper limit is 70 degrees. Lower limit is 0 degrees, exactly as displayed in the GUI. So now we know that the MIB variable for temperature is HM2 device management temperature, and it's located in the HM2 device management MIB. Now let's see if we can find the MIB variables for the power supply state. Sometimes the naming is a bit cryptic. Here we are. The power management MIB and the power supply variable HM2 power supply state. For power supply 1, the status is 1, and for power supply 2, the status is 2. As these statuses are numbers, they normally require enumeration to obtain the plain text meaning. For the enumeration, you need to look in the MIB. But in this case, the meaning is already clear, because we can see the same values in the GUI. 1 means present and 2 means defective. To save time, you can also search inside the packet. Type Ctrl F, then enter what you're looking for. Let's say temperature. That works well. Now we can try looking for power. But that does not work so well. Let's try another one. The status of the ACA external memory is always interesting. First, we find it in the GUI. Then we follow the standard procedure. Record, reload, stop. That has given us two packets. The first is a poll. The second one is what we are looking for. So the status of the external non-volatile memory is located in the HM2 dev management MIB, and the variable is HM2 external NVM status. So now you get the idea how this works. Let's check out the status of the high discovery protocol. This time we are lucky, no poll. Now you see the MIB variables for the high discovery operational status and the current mode. Let's do a couple more. How about how many VLANs are currently active? It is 2. Let's get the overall status of the device. In the GUI, you see it is error. There we are. HM2 dev mon oper state. And the overall security status. HM2 dev sec oper state. You may have noticed that these last two MIB variables we looked at are actually contained in the polls, because they are used for the mini dashboard. This technique works for most values in the switch GUI. So you see there's a great deal of information to select from, and you are sure to find what you're looking for. That leaves a couple of open points. During the video, I mentioned that you need to look in the MIB to find the enumeration, which will enable you to translate a numeric status to a plain text description. This is easy if you are an expert on MIBs, but if you are new to the subject, let me show you what I meant. Here is a folder containing the Hirschmann private MIBs. The last time I downloaded the MIBs, there were 61 of them. The enumeration example I used in the video was the power supply status. You remember this was in the power management MIB. So let's open the MIB in a text editor. Now we search for the MIB variable, which was HM2 PS state. And now you can see the enumeration. 1 equals present, 2 equals defective, 3 equals not installed, and 4 equals unknown. That's how to resolve the enumeration. That leaves one open point. To fully manage Hirschmann switches, you will normally need to import the Hirschmann private MIBs into your network management application. So, where can you get them from? the private MIBs are bundled with the Hirschmann switch software. Just download the switch software from the Belden website or the Hirschmann help desk, and you will have the private MIBs. So now you can spend your time designing an informative interface in your network management application rather than hunting for MIB variables.